Anderson collided in an all-out brawl with the World Tag Team Champion Doom. Now stay tuned for more action on World Championship Wrestling.
World Championship Wrestling is brought to you by Game Boy by Nintendo. Your power to go. Hello again, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Center Stage here in Atlanta, the home of the NWA. We've got a great program. Jim Ross and Bob Cottle with you, two big hours, and Bob, if the fans like tag team wrestling, this is a place to be.
Jim, you're right there. We're going to see some great tag teams, some exciting tag team action during this program. We're going to see the Southern Boys. The Fabulous Freebirds are going to be here. The Midnight Express, a team that has skyrocketed all the way to number three in the top 10 rankings, the Nasty Boys, against a team that we haven't seen. We want to see how they meld together, Ricky Morton and Tommy Rich.
And there's a big story behind that, ladies and gentlemen. We'll tell you a little bit later in the program, plus updates on Halloween Havoc. But right now, let's go up to Gary Capetta in our first event here on World Championship Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by Alan Iron Eagle, from the Mescalero Reservation in New Mexico, the Renegade Warriors. Their opponents total combined weight 525 pounds from Chicago, Illinois, the Ring Lords.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's the Ring Lords challenging the Renegade Warriors. Alan Iron Eagle will be with him at ringside.
Jim, he's down there sort of as a cheerleader or second for them over there in their corner. But I tell you, this young team, these young Renegades, off of the reservation, they've been outstanding in the times that we've seen them together in matches. Of course, they're brothers, the Youngblood brothers. They come from a great wrestling background. And they're just an outstanding tag team combination.
They've had their problems, Bob, with the Fabulous Freebirds on occasion. As a matter of fact, tomorrow on the main event, the Freebirds and a mystery partner will be wrestling the Renegade Warriors and Alan Iron Eagle.
And you know, a lot of the teams and a lot of the people are trying to be, are really getting into the mind game action, Jim, because the Freebirds are saying it's a mystery partner. We try to find out who it is, if it's Gordy. And here they are. They're the Freebirds. Who's the mystery partner, guys? Tell us
who's the mystery partner. What are you, a cop, Bob Cottle?
Yeah.
Guys, your mystery here tomorrow on TBS on the main event. Freebirds with a mystery partner against the Renegade Warriors and Alan Iron Eagle, 6:05 here on the main event. It's going to be Buddy Roberts in a reunion of the Birds.
How about Terry Gordy? Billy Gordon.
Nope.
Can't really say right now, Bob.
Take it easy, Bob. Take it easy. First of all, it's a big surprise tomorrow night on TBS. And if we told you, then you would go tell everybody and it wouldn't be a surprise. I mean, why would we do that?
I would like to ask you, Michael, why are you on such a vendetta against these fine Native American athletes, the Renegade Warriors, and especially young Alan Iron Eagle?
Nice guys that they are, too. They're extremely nice guys.
Well, that might be your opinion, but I'm going to tell you, I'm going to give you a little scoop here, baby. You can tell by the color of hair, I am a great descendant. My great-great-great-grandfather was General Custard to y'all, Uncle George to me. That's George right. Armstrong Custard, and I don't forget nothing.
Little Bighorn was a long time ago, Michael.
Hey, well, we're going to have a remembrance at Halloween Havoc, and we're going to start out tomorrow night at TBS, and we're going to take this guy, and he's going to become a major star the minute he walks out with him. Ain't that right, Little Richard?
Good God, I'm missing about a surprise tomorrow, Jim Ross.
All right, it's going to be a surprise.
All right, well, look, I think we're going to get just a closer look, you know, kind of bird's eye view.
We can't see real well from here.
Yeah.
All right, the Freebirds leaving us. I don't like the way this one looks, Bob.
No, I don't either, Jim. And they say they want to get a closer look, a bird's eye view. I tell you, there's a lot to view with this young team up there because they're just tremendous, Jim. They got all the size that you need to be an outstanding team, as well as they got tremendous athletic ability. Watch out. I'm like you. I don't like this.
The Freebirds and Little Richard Marley.
Mystery will be a mystery no longer.
Michael Hayes, a big surprise, he says. Nice move there by the Ring Lord. The Renegade Warriors. Outstanding combination. These young kids are really an enthusiastic tag team. There's a good move by the Ring Lords. Ring Lord 1 and 2. That's the number one Ring Lord in there right now.
Well, Jim, the Ring Lords, we've seen them several times in recent weeks also. And I tell you, they keep improving. They're really looking good in the ring.
Lateral press there near a fall. Be a great feather, no pun intended, in the cap of the Ring Lords if they could upset the Renegade Warriors here. And, of course, the Freebirds will be taking on the Renegade Warriors 1 week from tonight exclusively on pay-per-view at Halloween Havoc.
Jim, that's the big night right down on the floor. Boy, I tell you.
Freebirds keeping their distance here. That would cause a disqualification for the Ring Lords if they interfere. But I'm sure that the Freebirds are enjoying what they're seeing. The Freebirds with a mystery partner. Could it be a reunion with Buddy Roberts? Could it be a reunion with Terry Bam Bam Gordy?
Well, they've denied that. They said definitely that's not it. But I tell you, you cannot believe what they say, and you can't put anything past the two Freebirds.
It wouldn't surprise me to see Buddy Roberts or Terry Gordy or both of them here on the main event tomorrow night. Downstairs goes the Renegade Warrior, Mark and Chris Youngblood. Comprise the Renegade Warriors, they're brothers. Chris is the younger of the two, and he's in the ring right now. Ring Lord number two back in the ring.
Jimmy got that foot high in the air, had that leg extended straight out, and it landed right on the button.
Nice shot there by Chris Youngblood of the Renegade Warriors, and Ring Lord number two. Ring Lord, I'll tell you, we saw them bob against the Rock and Roll Express not too long ago. A very competitive young team. And right there, he ran face first right into the feet of Chris Youngblood.
When you say competitive, they put up a great fight, Jim. They were in it all the way.
Still to come in our first hour, the Fabulous Freebirds will be wrestling a live Louisville Slugger with Jim Cornette. Gordon Soley with the special edition of the Wrestling News Network. There's the power slam.
And the leg hook couldn't hold him, though, only the count of one. He kicked out quickly.
Front face lock. And now the Ring Lord going up top comes off the double axe handle on Chris Youngblood. And the younger member of the Renegade Warriors being really challenged here.
Fans, let me remind all you great NWA and World Championship Wrestling fans that tonight we're going to be in Charleston, South Carolina. There'll be great action there. And in Asbury Park, New Jersey. And then tomorrow night, one of our favorite towns, Jim, Baltimore, for the Baltimore Arena.
I know promoter Gary Judge's got a great card in Baltimore. And the Ring Lord missed that big move off the top rope. Chris Youngblood tags in his brother Mark. And now Mark Youngblood getting some momentum off the ropes with that tomahawk. Good drop kick there. Renegade Warriors on the warpath, so to speak. Cool kick right in the face. Good move.
Well, he had a lot of steam, too, coming right off of the rope. He was under a full head of power right into that foot.
Here comes one of their patented moves. This is their coup de grace right here. Alan Iron Eagle keeping the Ring Lord at bay on the outside. Tomahawk chop right off the top rope for the Renegade Warriors. Have won it here on World Championship Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the Renegade Warriors.
The three young Indian lads you see in the ring will take on the Freebirds and that mystery partner. Who will it be? What major star have the Freebirds recruited for tomorrow night's main event?
All right, and fans, again, watch it. In slow motion, you see that tremendous tomahawk chop off of the top rope, and there are your winners.
Fans, we'll be back. The Fabulous Freebirds are in action. And still to come, a live Louisville Slugger with James E. Cornette next on TBS.
Their opponents, total combined weight, 475 pounds. From Gunstown, Virginia, Mark White. And from the Great Smoky Mountains, Jim Corbin.
Jim Corbin and Mark White to take on the Fabulous Freebirds here on World Championship Wrestling. Welcome back, everyone. Fans already chanting for the DDT.
somewhat prematurely, I might add.
Well, that's a favorite move, of course, of the Freebirds, Jim, and if they ever get the DDT on an opponent, I don't think I've ever seen anybody able to get up from the DDT when Michael Hayes or Jimmy Garvin put it on.
Bob, while we had the chance, let's tell the fans about this Monday night. Big doings, as they say, in the North Georgia Mountains.
You're right, Jim. Monday night, 7:30 p.m., Gainesville, Georgia, Georgia Mountain Center. Over 30 straight great stars from the NWA are going to be there for our national TV taping, and that's Monday night. Also, while I'm at it, Jim, I may remind all the fans around Sumter, South Carolina, we're going to be there Tuesday in one of my favorite towns, Savannah, Georgia, on Wednesday. And the countdown has begun. We're right now 1 week away, and we're counting, Jim, of course, to the big event of the season, Halloween Havoc, exclusively on pay-per-view.
It's the World Series for professional wrestling, exclusively on pay-per-view, as Bob Cottle mentioned. The fabulous Freebirds. I tell you, they've really got my curiosity aroused, Bob, because tomorrow, with Missy Hyatt and me here on the NWA main event at 6:05 tomorrow night, Eastern Time, by the way, the Freebirds and the Mystery Partner, and I know it's not going to be Little Richard Marley. They would not go into a match against a great trio like the three Indian youngsters. They're going to come loaded for bear. I'm just wondering what star that they will have tomorrow night on the program.
Yeah, Jim, I think now we're all going to be wondering that. And, of course, you're not going to get it out of the Freebirds. They're not going to tell you that. But if Michael Hayes is a descendant of Custer, do you think maybe the Warriors may be taking a scalp or two?
They just might. I'm somewhat dubious of that story about Michael Hayes' family tree. Jim Corbin trying to show some offense, but Hayes holding on tenaciously with that arm, and then he nailed him with a left hand.
Oh, man, he had some power behind that. And, you know, the Freebirds, they're so flashy, Jim, and they talk so much, but they back a lot of it up. And sometimes we overlook the fact that they're such a tremendous tag team wrestling team, and that they are.
You're right, Bob. They're the former tag team champions of the world, and they certainly feel, and I agree, that they have the ability to regain those championships if given the opportunity. Hayes working over Jim Corbin, tags in Jimmy Jam Garvin. This team of the Freebirds, a veteran duo, they make very few mistakes, very little wasted motion in the ring.
Well, they're the kind of team, too, that's going to take a win any way they can get it. All they want is that W in that column, Jim. They don't care how. They don't care whether it's little Richard outside of the ring that helps them or whatever. They want the W.
Mark White being brutalized there, and there you see little Richard Marley with a cheap shot and a DDT on Mark White on the outside. Well, the referee would have seen that. There would have been a disqualification right there. Unfortunately, the Freebirds had the official detained on the other side of the ring. Freebirds genuinely enjoy beating up their opponents.
Oh, they like to inflict that pain. And I tell you, White and Corbin, I think the thing in this match, Jim, is just going to be extremely difficult for them to overcome the experience of the Freebirds. You know, Hayes has been wrestling since he was 17 years old, and Garvin's been around 13 or 14 years. They got a tremendous amount of wrestling experience in that corner.
Still young men
right.
In the sport. They are really, I think, just getting into their prime as far as I'm concerned. Fans have asked for it. This then Mark White goes to the ropes. And that has really upset Michael Hayes as he's nailing White with everything but the kitchen sink. Got him with an elbow there.
Well, White hooked that rope, and Jim, you can't blame him. He heard that chant also about the DDT, and Hayes had him almost set up for it. So quickly, he just hooked that arm around the rope.
Anyone that has scouted the Freebirds knows that their DDT is one of their favorite offensive weapons, and there's a big chop reminiscent of the legendary Nature Boy Ric Flair. Another chop by Hayes. Great action in our first hour, as we mentioned, special edition of the Wrestling News Network. Gordon Solie focusing on two of the championship matches at Halloween Havoc, and it looks like it might be the DDT here. It may be stereo DDT.
Yeah.
A pair of headaches, and I'm not talking about the Freebirds. They're happy that they've won. Who will be their partner tomorrow night? We're going to show little Richard Marley involved in this situation with that DDT. Bob, this is totally distasteful.
It is, Jim, and outside of the ring, and he really put the power on. See, he got off of the floor, put all of his weight down on that DDT, and then, as you say, here's one in stereo to wrap it up.
The Freebirds with a victory, and they will be taking on the Renegade Warriors. Who will be their partner tomorrow night? Maybe Jim Cornette can find out. He's standing by live in the Louisville Slugger.
Well, here we are back on World Championship Wrestling, a special edition of the Louisville Slugger tonight, and my guests, the fabulous Freebirds, the world's greatest rock and roll band, and little Richard Marley right here. You said you'd control him, Michael.
He's fine. Just take it easy, little Richard. He gets excited. Center stage. Been a long time since we rock and roll. Now, I know already Sherlock Jim Ross and Lieutenant Bob Caudle. Everybody wants to know who's going to be our mystery partner tomorrow night.
That's right. Tomorrow night on the main event, it's going to be those three Indians against you guys and a mystery partner. Now, I got to know who it is. Is it Buddy Roberts?
No.
Could be.
Well, wait a minute. Is it Terry Gordy? Come on, Jimmy.
Could be.
Well, wait, who is going to be you guys' mystery partner against the three Indians tomorrow night here on the main event on TBS?
I'll tell you what. I would love to tell you, and as a matter of fact, we will tell you off the air.
Wow, I wanted to get a scoop here on the program.
But
you know,
it's a big
slugger.
Surprise we've been planning for a long
time.
Well,
if you want to get a scoop, you better scoop your cell phone out of here, because ain't nobody going to find out till tomorrow. I'll give you one scoop. Those Indians, they don't know nothing because their ancestors always drinking too much fire water.
You mean to tell me they speak with a fork? Wait a minute. Hold on here.
Freebirds, I don't care what it is. We're tired of disgracing our people. We wear pink because we're warriors, not sissies.
Wait a minute. Now, come on. We don't want to get a fight here. This is my show.
What, are you a little nervous about something? Are you a little nervous about
it? We don't have to wait till tomorrow. We'll do battle right now. Come on.
Wait a minute now.
You're going to have to wait, baby. You're going to have to wait.
Let's get out of here. Let's go to a break. I'm getting out of here.
Welcome to the Wrestling News Network special edition. This week, we're going to concentrate on both the U.S. Tag Team Championship and the U.S. Heavyweight Championship. Recently in Chicago, a situation occurred between the Steiners and the Nasty Boys. Well, now they have reached a critical crossroads in their career. It will be settled 1 week from tonight at Halloween Havoc. We're going to take a look at that incident as it occurred in Chicago. Then we'll hear some comments from the Steiners and from the Nasty Boys about their meeting October 27th, pay-per-view Halloween Havoc.
Well, you got one thing right. You're next.
Scott?
The next time you defend these belts, it'll be the last. Did everybody see that? I hope they took a good look. You two stupid college punks, we let you land and bloody. Come October 27th, Halloween Havoc, you're looking at the new United States Tag Team Champions.
The thing about it is, Steiners, you in Chicago haven't seen nothing yet. Not an inch of what the Nasty Boys could dish out. New York City, Nasty equals United States Tag Team title.
You know, Nasty Boys, everybody sees you hit me with the belt, slam my brother on the table, big deal. That's the way we like it. Rough and tough, draw a little blood, big deal. Funny games to us. When it comes back to Chicago, you better expect something else. They say, hey, watch the blood, watch their legs, watch them. You watch them. It's your body. You take care of it.
Nasty Boys, you started something. You had us down, but we're never out. Next time, we don't care about the belts. We want you.
A rough battle upcoming for the U.S. Tag Team Championship. Now, let's go back to the Clash 12 of Clash of Champions and a situation regarding the challenger for the U.S. Heavyweight Championship, Stan Hansen, and the total package Lex Luger, who is currently the U.S. champion. They, too, will meet at Halloween Havoc. The U.S. Championship goes on the line. But here's what happened at Clash of Champions 12 between Stan Hansen and Lex Luger. So it's all happening in just 1 week. Halloween Havoc. It takes place October 27th. We're waiting now for Lex Luger, the total package, to appear. And we don't have Lex Luger for some reason.
Oh, you mean somebody sent Lex Luger to the wrong studio? They told me to send a message over telling him to be in studio. But I didn't know he's supposed to be in studio, eh, Gordon? I'm so sorry. You mean they sent him to the wrong studio? Oh, man, you want to do this segment over again? I'll go find him if you want me to.
Well, unfortunately, we can't do that right now, but I suspicion in my own mind that you've had something to do with messing
up? No, I would never mess up your segment. Gordon, you know, you are my favorite journalist in professional wrestling, but I tell you what, since I'm out here right now and I'm on TV, I'd like to invite you and everybody else out there 1 week from tonight at Halloween Havoc, live on pay-per-view. I'd like to invite everybody to the big victory celebration I'm throwing for Stan Hansen after he defeats Lex Luger for the United States Heavyweight Championship. And guess what, Gordon? We're going to have a real nice Western theme, and everybody that comes into the nightclub gets a cowboy hat.
Well,
and by the way, if you'd like, I'll go find Lex Luger for you right now before your segment's over so you can interview him. Oh, Luger!
Yeah. Thanks a whole bunch. Well, as I said, this was a Wrestling News Network special edition. I had no idea how special it was going to be. But payback time, next Saturday night, Halloween Havoc.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest on World Championship Wrestling, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Vero Beach, Florida, weighing 238 pounds, Terry Taylor.
Great ovation for Terry Taylor.
His opponent from Oil Trough, Texas, 227 pounds, Dirty Dutch Mantell.
Dirty Dutch Mantell. And Terry Taylor, two of the great stars here in World Championship Wrestling. Big match for both men, both outstanding competitors. They prepared for this match. We were excited when we heard it was signed. This should be an outstanding contest. They both have a lot to prove here in World Championship Wrestling in the NWA.
Jim, they do that. Terry Taylor is technically sound, good wrestler. He has the skills that really allows him to use his speed and his quickness. And, of course, Mantell, he's the type of wrestler you can never drop your guard on, Dutch Mantell. Boy, he'll stick it to you.
He's a great athlete.
Yes, sir.
As is Terry Taylor, collar and elbow tie up. And Taylor with a good arm drag takeover right into that arm bar. And Dutch Mantell rolling away from the pressure back up to his base, trying to fight away from that pressure.
Jim, I was just sitting here thinking, Gordon Sully, and we got to look at what Stan Hansen has done to Lex Luger. You know, we're going to have some showdowns and some big showdowns 1 week from tonight, of course, at Halloween Havoc. One of them is going to be that Hansen-Luger situation.
Paul Lee, such a jerk to enter. I tell you something, he needs to be muzzled.
Well, and of course, the other one that I'm really looking forward to, and that's the Steiners match. Well, Jim, you got two teams. When they collide there, I think you can hear that explosion all over Chicago when they meet.
I still think about their belts, as we saw, being smashed on their faces by the Nasty Boys. The Nasty Boys are in this program, the number three ranked tag team in the world. They'll take on Ricky Morton and Tommy Rich. We'll talk more about that situation a little bit later in the program. There's a story behind the story, so to speak.
That's right, Jim. I think you're going to have some news, and it's not going to be good news for all the fans, of course, about Robert Gibson.
We're still waiting on another report, and we'll hope to have that in the next 10 or 15 minutes. Mantel with a lateral press. Randy Anderson down. Got two out of it. Mantel is a double tough customer from Oil Trough, Texas. A real outdoorsman. Usually seen with a some of that smokeless tobacco in his lip. I certainly don't advocate the use of that, but Mantel is an adult, and unfortunately, sometimes we adults make decisions that aren't always for our best health.
And I think you called him dirty, and I guess, you know, we might say that might be sort of a dirty habit, Jim.
Mantel catching Taylor coming in, caught him right in the face with his foot. Oh, right there. Taylor got the left shoulder up. I tell you, I think back, Bob, at the Louisville Slugger, the Renegade Warriors were ready to go on the warpath right here. They didn't necessarily want to wait until tomorrow's main event.
And I don't know who that mystery partner is, Jim, and after hearing from the Freebirds a couple of times about it, I'm even more confused, I think, than I was before. But I tell you one thing, he better be dadgum good, because the Renegade Warriors and Iron Eagle, they're going to be ready.
Dutch Mantel was using the rope for leverage in that abdominal stretch. That's a very painful hold. He's got Taylor's hair as well. Mantel will take every shortcut he can. He certainly throws the rule book out the pickup window.
And he's always thinking about that. He's always looking for something to get the little edge, something extra that he can do. It's going to give him just the teeny tiniest bit of advantage, and he'll take it.
Bob, as we said, we're 1 week away from Halloween Havoc. We've got some special wrestling hotline coverage of that event as well. Lance Russell, Gordon Sully will be covering it live this coming Saturday night.
That's right, Jim. 1-900-909-9900, the wrestling hotline. By the way, you're going to be there tonight. All the fans can call up and hear Jim tonight, but live coverage of Halloween Havoc, fans. That's going to be next Saturday night.
Of course, the fans will be able to call in starting at 7 o'clock and talk live to Sid Vicious and Arn Anderson. Speak their mind to two of the horsemen. That'll be beginning at 7 o'clock next Saturday night. Roll up there by Terry Taylor. And Taylor went for the drop kick, but the veteran from Oil Trough moved out of the way, quick to take care of the moment. He sees the moment right there like a great veteran athlete will do and go for the pin.
And again, he had to count a two on Terry Taylor, Jim. Taylor's been close to being pinned now two or three times by Mantel.
Terry Taylor with a right hand. Mantel follows up with one of his own. Mantel's got that right hand heavily taped. Somewhat of a trademark of his.
That's why we're talking, too, about next Saturday night. We want to remind all of you fans, and Jim, this is a real great one. Toronto, Canada, next Thursday night. The NWA will be there in Toronto. And also in Norfolk, Virginia on Thursday. And then in Friday in Saginaw, Michigan, and in Richmond, Virginia. And then next Saturday night, don't forget, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, 6 p.m. Central, exclusively on pay-per-view. That's the big Halloween Havoc.
Terry Taylor being battered now by Dirty Dutch Mantel. But Taylor blocked the move and rams Mantel's rather hairy features into the top turnbuckle. And Taylor comes back into the ring. Taylor drops him down. Well, that would cure an overbite.
Man, and if he had his tongue between his teeth, he's minus a little bit of it right now.
Taylor with that atomic drop follows up with a belly-to-back suplex. Good move by Taylor. And now Taylor on top, going for the pin. 1-2, but Mantel kicks out. Taylor went for the elbow. Mantel moves.
Well, as we say, he's a ring-wise veteran. And Taylor didn't hook the leg, and he was a little slow coming with that elbow drop.
Mantel with a sleeper on Terry Taylor. Taylor knows Mantel is proficient in this hold, trying to reach for the ropes. Mantel trying to position Taylor in the center of the ring away from those ropes.
Jim, even if you're able to withstand this, if you break it some way, and it's a hard hold to break, but Taylor just did, it still takes a lot out of you.
Cuts off the flow of blood to the brain. Really causes that, does induce a sleep-like condition, renders the opponent unconscious, but Terry Taylor very conscious now, the rights and lefts, but Mantel rakes the eyes blatantly. Now it's Mantel with a snap suplex. Dirty Dutch Mantel measuring. Taylor went for the knee drop. He missed it there. And it's Taylor caught him. Taylor's got him rolled up. And 1-2-3, Taylor wins it.
Here's our winner, Terry Taylor.
A close, hard-fought match. Terry Taylor with a well-earned victory here on World Championship Wrestling.
And fans, as we look at it again, Right here you see Terry Taylor in the sleeper as Dutch Mantel has it in. Taylor again as he dropped to the mat, got that head right under the chin. And again, Mantell comes up holding that mouth. But coming off the ropes, watch that great move right here by Taylor to roll him up for the pin, 1-2-3.
Taylor avoided the knee drop right into the midsection, came up with a rolling cradle. Taylor has won it. And fans, here's a look at the lineup for 1 week from tonight at Halloween Havoc. It's exclusively on pay-per-view.
The eyes of the wrestling world are focused on Halloween Havoc, upcoming in Chicago. Exclusively pay-per-view, Halloween, October 27th, Saturday night. It begins at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The NWA World Championship goes on the line. Sting defending his title against the challenge of Big Sid Vicious. And then the U.S. Heavyweight Championship. The total package, Lex Luger, defending his title against Stan Hansen. The World Tag Team Championship. Doom defends its title against Ric Flair and Arn Anderson. And the U.S. Tag Team titles, the Steiner Brothers face the Nasty Boys. You'll see the Renegade Warriors against the Fabulous Freebirds. The Junkyard Dog takes on Moondog. Tommy Rich faces J.W. Storm. Southern Boys against the Master Blasters. Terry Taylor against Wildcat Wendell Cooley. And the Rock and Roll Express against the Midnight Express. Saturday night, October 27th, Halloween Havoc, exclusive pay-per-view.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, parts unknown, weighing 318 pounds, Moondog Rex. His opponent from Los Angeles, California, weighing 236 pounds, Rick Ford.
Rick Ford, an outstanding young competitor to challenge the big 300-pound Moondog, who's got that rather large bone, and referee Mike Atkins trying to converse with this very deranged individual. He's got to put that bone away. I don't blame Rick Ford for staying outside until that bone is properly disposed of.
A very smart and alert move on the part of Rick Ford to get out of that ring while he's got that bone in that hand. Jim, that's not only a bone, that's like a club. That's how large that son of a gun is.
We'll find out who the biggest dog in the yard is in 1 week, because Moondog Rex will take on the Junkyard Dog exclusively on pay-per-view at Halloween Havoc.
Yeah, Battle of the Dogs. We're going to have a top dog after that, I guess, huh?
Maybe the winner gets a case of Alpo or something, Bob. I don't know.
that's gonna be some match, though, as you say, the Battle of the Dogs. These two, both of them are such big, huge, strong individuals.
Moondog Rex, very powerful man. Rick Ford tried to put him down, but he couldn't do it there. Straight right hand by Ford and a forearm. But the Moondog with a headbutt got him right in the face.
Well, that just shows you his power, Jim. He took that block coming off of the ropes. Then he took those two right hands, still on his feet.
Moondog, a very deliberate athlete. He is a very methodical in his style and his technique. Ricking the face of Rick Ford. We'll hear some comments in a few moments from Ricky Morton. See, and Tommy Rich will team for the first time here in World Championship Wrestling to take on the Nasty Boys. Alan Iron Eagle in action as well. Still to come in this segment.
Jim, that's not a very enviable task. I don't think either, taking on a team like the Nasty Boys. The very first time they'll be going to the ring as a team.
It's going to be a great challenge for Tommy Rich and Ricky Morton, but they are tremendous athletes. They've known each other since they both got into the sport. Nice single leg pickup there by Rick Ford, and Ford on top, trying to hammer the big Moondog, but the Moondog, I don't think even feels those blows, Bob. If he does, he's certainly not... Doesn't show any effect anyway. Comes up with that elbow.
Very deliberate, extremely strong, punishing type of wrestler. He's certainly out to land the heavier blows and wear the opponent down, Jim. He's really a brawler in the ring.
High impact move there by Moondog Rex. Dropping the knee viciously right in the face. Great camera shots taking you right inside the ring. You can see the impact there. Three knees right to the side of the head. Clubbing blow of the elbow there. In our second hour, Gordon Solie in the wrestling wrap-up. We'll have some comments from Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, along with Theodore R. Long, as they look at the championship situations at Halloween Havoc. There's a fall-away slam by Moondog Rex, who's on top. 1, 2, 3, and the Moondog with a victory. Here's a neck breaker from the Moondog, and this is a very punishing maneuver. The Junkyard Dog must beware.
He has such tremendous power in that upper body, and Jim, this fallaway slam, if he ever gets you in a position of that, he's going to put you down for the count, as he does Rick Ford here.
As we said, Ricky Morton and Tommy Rich to take on the Nasty Boys in just a few moments. Here are comments from Ricky Morton.
You know, Nasty Boys, you have come in here to the NWA by storm, taking over, trying to walk over people. But you see, you come out here and you challenge the Rock and Roll Express. But you see, my partner can't be here today because he had a benefit for the deaf. But let me tell you one thing, I'm not out in the cold. I always have an ace in the hole. So be ready, Nasty Boys. The Wildfire Tommy Rich is going to come in, stand by my side, and we'll see how nasty the Nasty Boys can really get later on here today.
The following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Manawaka, Kansas, weighing 251 pounds, Alan Iron Eagle. His opponent from Chattanooga, Tennessee, 226 pounds, Greg Sawyer.
Interesting comments from Ricky Morton. He and Tommy Rich to take on the Nasty Boys, still to come here on World Championship Wrestling. And Alan Iron Eagle, and he's got his brothers in arms, the Renegade Warriors, Chris and Mark Youngblood at ringside. And I think they're not only here to support their young warrior, but also to make sure that the Freebirds don't decide to take advantage of this 19-year-old kid again.
Well, that's exactly what the Freebirds are apt to do, Jim. And it's a good thing that the Warriors were thinking about that, the Youngbloods were, because if they're able to isolate him, boy, it could be bad trouble. And they just put him out of action right there.
Clothesline and a lateral press. Greg Sawyer going for the pin. Well, the Indians having some fun there at ringside. They're here to watch their friend, maybe perhaps we could call him a protege. I understand he's 19 years of age, Alan Iron Eagle. But the Freebirds, who declined to wrestle the three of them earlier in the program, and knowing the Freebirds as we all do, they're there for a little insurance.
That's right. But Jim, they are going to wrestle them. They're going to wrestle them tomorrow at 6:05 along with their mystery partner right here on TBS. That's on the main event tomorrow. Hey, fans, you don't want to miss that. I want to just find out who the gall-dang mystery partner is.
Reverse chin lock there by Greg Sawyer on Alan Iron Eagle. We're seeing the metamorphosis of this young athlete as he is developing into an outstanding competitor. He's taking his lumps, to be quite honest. He's won more matches than he's lost, but he's always competitive. He's always in the thick of things. And the one thing that I think all the young athletes watching our program can identify with this is that you just never give up. You always try to keep improving.
And, Jim, he's in them because of his skills, of course, but I think the thing, as you say, the reason he's taking his lumps, and there's no way to get around that fact, the one important factor and the only thing that age can do for you, and that's give you experience. He lacks the experience factor.
Nice move. There, he tripped there a little bit, but he had a good move.
Yes, sir.
Trying to execute a good drop kick, but that one there, he was set a little bit too. He was a little too slow setting up for the drop kick. And Greg Sawyer, who has more experience, now taking over, blatantly kicking Alan Iron Eagle in the ribs.
That's one of the things he's got to do, Jim, and with the experience will come that, of course, that he don't want to telegraph his punches. And, of course, he did that on that drop kick. As you say, he was a little far back. Sawyer saw that coming. He was able to avoid it.
Sawyer wants to make a name for himself right here at Alan Iron Eagle's expense. Nice elevation there by Sawyer. Fans still to come in our second hour. You will hear the wrestling wrap-up with Gordon Solie as he focuses squarely on the world championships to be decided 1 week from tonight at Halloween Havoc. He'll look into the Ric Flair, Arn Anderson doom situation with the world tag team titles, and then take an in-depth look, and he'll be talking to Sid Vicious. As Sid Vicious says, he will be the next world's champion. We'll also hear from the world champion Sting in the second hour. And now Alan Iron Eagle firing up. There's that tomahawk slap and another chop right on the chest. Sawyer sent to the ropes. Good chop there. He got all of it there. He's great behind the leg, good style, and a victory for Alan Iron Eagle.
Here's your winner, Alan Iron Eagle.
It'll be Alan Iron Eagle and the Renegade Warriors tomorrow here on the main event. But the big question remains, who will be the mystery partner of the Freebirds?
Wrestling fans, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing, from New York City, the Nasty Boys.
They are the number three ranked tag team in the world. 1 week from tonight, they will collide with the Steiner Brothers for the United States Tag Team Championship. But I'll tell you, Bob, if they look past the team that's about to be introduced, they're going to go down tonight here from center stage.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, first from Atlanta, Georgia, he weighs 218 pounds, Wildfire, Tommy Briggs. His tag team partner, Memphis, Tennessee, one half of the Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton.
What an ovation for Morton and Rich. This place really rocking and rolling now.
Well, the crowd loves them. And Jim, the Rock and Roll Express, really probably one of the most popular, if not the most popular tag team ever in the NWA. And the fans, they reflect that every time they enter the arena.
About the piece of information we were waiting on, that Robert Gibson, ladies and gentlemen, has been injured. The details are very sketchy. He is being examined as we speak. At our team physician in Atlanta, Dr. Fred Allman, and the extent of his injury is yet to be determined. We don't know all the details. Ricky Morton would not discuss it before we went on the air, but we will hopefully have more information on that perhaps tomorrow on the main event, or at the latest next Saturday here on World Championship Wrestling.
Well, Jim, we just hope and pray that it's not a serious injury to him, because I tell you, it'd be a really sad blow for something like that to happen to this team right now.
The Nasty Boys starting out that power match, showing their power, but Morton and Rich will be the quicker team by far. Good hip-hop takeover by Ricky Morton. And a drop kick. Sends Knobs right out of the ring. And the crowd here loves it in the center stage.
Well, it's certainly not always power and strength in there when you've got the agility and the athletic ability and you know how to use your leverage and get around like Morton does, Jim. You can go up against a man the size of the Nasty Boys.
I think the strategy for Ricky Morton there and his partner Tommy Rich is to use their quickness advantage and hopefully be able to take the Nasty Boys off their feet, and that's going to negate some of the strategy. Yeah. And that's what they're doing right now, is talking strategy.
Yeah, I tell you, when you talk about Ricky Morton and Tommy Rich using their quickness and their agility, I have to think, what will the Steiners do against a team like this? Jim, the Steiners, well, they're great athletes, and they're just bullheaded enough. They're going to stand toe-to-toe. This could really be some wild collision when these four get together.
It's going to be some serious dues paid.
Oh,
1 week from tonight when the Steiners take on the Nasty Boys, and now Jerry Sags of the Nasty Boys has slowed the pace down with those powerful knees right to the solar plexus. Irish Rich, Ricky Morton in, and Morton quickly moves out of the way. Jerry Sags went all the way to the steel ring post. He rolls back in the ring. That's great quickness by Ricky Morton. And now Ricky Morton tags in Tommy Wildfire Rich. And it's Wildfire on the second turnbuckle. Taking that arm, another turn, working on the wrist lock.
Well, we talk about how the Nasty Boys have just skyrocketed up in the rankings all the way to number three. But when you look across there, of course, the Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton with his partner, they've been tag team champions four times, Jim. Tommy Rich in that corner with Rich right now has been a world champion. They've got experience over there.
Good arm drag takeovers by Tommy Wildfire Rich. Great strategy by the popular young duo that we're seeing for the very first time here on World Championship Wrestling. Both these young men are natives of the Volunteer State of Tennessee. They've been around each other virtually their entire career. Ricky, of course, grew up in Memphis. Tommy Rich grew up in Hendersonville, Tennessee.
I've been watching them too, Jim, and there's no indecision on their part. It's not like a new tag team, the way they're working. They're very smooth at the moment, and they're tagging, and they're switching often in the ring.
Again, Morton used his quickness to roll out of the way and avoid the elbow. And Tommy Rich tags back in. We may be seeing an upset in the making right here, because Tommy Rich And Ricky Morton really came to fight. I tried to talk to Ricky. Another arm drag, taking the bigger man, a 300-pounder, right off his feet, right to the canvas.
As you mentioned earlier, they want to get him on the mat, keep him on the mat if they can. That way they're not going to be able to use that strength and that power. You've got to be careful of the Nasty Boys, Jim. Their top move is the death drop, and of course that's a combination of the power slam and a top elbow drop off the rope, and that thing is a vicious blow.
Much like the Frankensteiner or the Steiner line. Good move there by Ricky Morton, using leverage. Got in very deeply to take over. As you can easily see, a much bigger man. That man, Brian Knobbs, got to be just over 300 pounds. And Jerry Sags tried to come in and get involved. And Tommy Rich, with his experience, came right across and prevented that interference.
Jim, I know a lot of the fans are thinking, how does a man that size do that? But let me tell you, I know you've done it and I've done it. We've been in and we've seen the college wrestlers. I've seen 118-pound, 120-pound college wrestlers take the big 250-pound football lineman and just throw him around on the mat like he was nothing.
Leverage is the name of the game. Leverage and technique. There's some funny stories come out of a wrestling room where the football players want to challenge some of those wrestlers in the smaller weights, and those big offensive or defensive linemen get tied to a knot. And that's what Morton and Rich hope to do here. But again now, Brian Knobbs of the Nasty Boys has slowed it down, hammering away with a lot of force. And that's what they like to do, wrestle with force. But Tommy Rich, I think he likes to fight, and that right hand finding his home there.
He's very aptly named Wildfire. As you say, he really loves to turn it on, Jim. He likes to go full bore in the ring, and he'll stand toe-to-toe with you.
I want to remind the fans, I hope they will join us here at Center Stage. Our next television taping is 1 week from this Tuesday night. Begins at 7 o'clock here. Certainly not a bad seat in the house. I don't think there's any better arena in America to watch wrestling than right here at Center Stage on West Peachtree.
Jim, as you say, every single seat is a good seat. You can see all of the action. And not only that, but the fans are close to the ring. They're close to the action in the ring. And it's just an enthusiastic setting.
Great combination of moves there by Morton and Rich. And Tommy Rich back into the wrist lock.
Fans, this is the kind of action you can see tonight in Charleston, South Carolina, and in Asbury Park, New Jersey. World Championship Wrestling is right there.
From behind, it was Brian Knobbs nailing Tommy Rich. And on the outside, Jerry Sags caught him with a clothesline. Fans, we're going to be right back with more of this tremendous main event after this timeout. And we are back here, ladies and gentlemen. Jim Ross and Bob Caudill here on TBS and World Championship Wrestling, coming to you from the center stage in Atlanta, the home of the NWA. It's Tommy Wildfire Rich and Ricky Morton joining forces for the first time against the Nasty Boys, the hottest team perhaps in wrestling right now. And it has been a phenomenal battle. Actually, I got to give the nod to Rich and Morton until just a few moments ago, but now it's all Nasty Boys. As Jerry Sags went for a very arrogant pin there, and Tommy Rich kicked out.
The tide of the battle has certainly changed, Jim, as you mentioned, and it's the fact that the Nasty Boys have been able to withstand it. They've stayed in there, and I think it's just probably the fact that they are stronger, tougher, rougher individuals just because of their size and their power that they're able now to make this comeback.
Vertical suplex. Brian Knobbs perfectly positioned there, dropping Tommy Rich. Another high-impact move on top, lateral press. But the pugnacious Tommy Rich kicks out. And Ricky Morton trying to get the fans involved in this one.
You better believe that the Nasty Boys are well aware of the fact, Jim, that they can't afford to lose an upset bout right here because of what may happen next week. They don't want to go in to that championship match with the Steiners having a loss on their record.
Well, they have certainly been gaining a great deal of momentum, Bob, and they certainly don't want to lose it right here. But upset is on the minds of Ricky Morton and Tommy Rich, but right now Tommy Rich has got to survive this abdominal stretch, and with some help there from his friends on the outside, Tommy's got to free himself here, try to get in deep, get this big man off his back, and tag in Ricky Morton if possible. The Nasty Boys made the tag.
You better believe they're going to try to keep Rich away from that corner. They don't want him to make that tag.
High elevation by Jerry Sags on Tommy Wildfire Rich. In our second hour, Jim Cornette's Midnight Express, and Rich kicked out at two. Plus J.W. Storm, the Juicer, the Southern Boys. And Gordon Solie and the wrestling wrap-up will not only have comments from Ric Flair, Arn Anderson, Teddy Long, he'll be talking to Sid Vicious, and we'll hear from Sting as well. All that and more in our second hour, plus a live Trucker Norm's Corner. And every time I think about Norman eating a big chicken fried steak at one of those truck stops. A big one.
It would take a big one for Trucker Norm, and he's going to have the juicer over there. It'll be interesting to see what he and the juicer talk about when you get two like that together.
Single leg pickup by Jerry Sags, tagging in Brian Knobs and the Nasty Boys now with great teamwork, tagging in and out, keeping Tommy Wildfire Rich in the Nasty Boys half of the ring. The old cliche is certainly true here. This is indeed classic tag team strategy, keeping your opponent in your half of the ring. It's as if an imaginary line has been drawn diagonally across the squared circle, and that line is where they stay. They stay on their side of the ring.
Keep him from making the tag, but you got to be impressed. Even though, as we said, the tide of battle had changed, you got to be impressed with Rich and Morton, Jim, in their first bout as tag team partners. They made a tremendous showing already.
Bear hug, powering Tommy Rich back into the corner. That's the power advantage the Nasty Boys possess here. Sags missed the clothesline. And there's a neck breaker by Tommy Rich. Big play by Tommy Rich. A home run by Rich. Nasty Boys make the exchange, and here comes Ricky Morton.
Well, that could have been the equalizer.
Ricky Morton firing up on both the Nasty Boys. It's as if Morton is a man possessed, knowing that the career of his partner may be in jeopardy.
I think the crowd senses it.
Tommy Rich in there as well, all four men now. Randy Anderson trying to get control of the situation. Ricky Morton's got him rolled up. Morton's got him pinned.
Where's
the
ref?
Oh, the referee putting Tommy Rich out. What a clothesline by Jerry Sags on an unsuspecting Ricky Morton. And the Nasty Boys have won it here.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners. Jerry Sags, Brian Knobs, the Nasty Boys.
What a battle. Ricky Morton and Tommy Rich have just had the Nasty Boys. But 1 week from tonight, those two from New York City and the Steiners, and revenge on the Steiners' mind.
Well, they certainly gave them all they wanted and then more. As you see Morton roll him up, he had him rolled. A referee trying to put Rich out. He could have counted a half a dozen or more right here. And there's the clothesline to put Morton away.
The clothesline from the illegal man did it. The Nasty Boys say they'll be the next U.S. Tag Team Champions. More on that, but now look at the top tens.
Here's a look at the NWA's top 10 tag teams for this week. The number 10 team, the Master Blaster. Number 9, Flying Brian the Z-Man. Rank 8, Mike Rotunda and Jim Horner. The Southern Boys are number 7. The Midnight Express checks in at number 6. Number 5, the Fabulous Freebirds. Rock and Roll Express, rank 4. Number 3, moving up, the Nasty Boys. The number 2 team, Ric Flair and Arn Anderson. The number 1 ranked team, the U.S. Tag Team Champions, the Steiners. And, of course, the Tag Team Champions of the World, Ron Simmons, Butch Reed, the Team of Doom. Here's a look at the singles ratings for NWA this week. Barry Windham ranks in at number 10. Number 9, the Nature Boy, Buddy Landell. The Junkyard Dog is number 8. Jerry Taylor, number 7. Followed by number 6, Flying Brian. The World Television Champion, Arn Anderson, ranked 5th. Number 4, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Followed by the number 3 man, Stan the Lariat Hansen. Sid Vicious is number 2. The number 1 man, of course, the U.S. Champion, Total Package Lex Luger. And the heavyweight champion of the world, of course, is Sting. That's a look at this week's ranking.
Welcome to the Wrestling Wrap-Up. The Wrestling Wrap-Up, of course, is brought to you by The Wrap-Up, the official publication of the NWA, and it is available wherever NWA wrestling is held. Our concentration today will be on the World Tag Team Championship and also on the World Heavyweight Championship. Recently in Greensboro, a situation occurred between the Horsemen and the Team of Doom. After that, we're going to be hearing from Teddy Long and also from the Horsemen. Now, let's go to Greensboro.
What a battle we've seen here in Greensboro between the Horsemen. There's the DDT by Arn Anderson on Hacksaw Butch Reed. And Ron Simmons prevents the pin. This one has gone back and forth. One of the most fiercely competitive tag team battles I've ever witnessed. Anderson rolls outside and Simmons follows him. What a titanic showdown. In Chicago on Saturday night, October October 27th between these two. The bad blood is boiling here, and Flair rammed into the post. The Horseman and Dune, the referee, has lost control. He's disqualifying both teams. They're fighting all the way down the aisle. What a battle, what a war.
As I was sitting down talking to Godmama Oprah Winfrey, she said to me, she said, Godfather Teddy Long, October 27, Halloween Havoc, the world titles go on the line. It's the Horsemen, Ric Flair and Arn Anderson want a chance at the gold. Well, the Rock and Roll Express couldn't take them, the Steiners couldn't take them, and anybody else that we stepped in the ring couldn't take the world titles from the Soul Brothers Doom. And I'm going to make sure that you, Ric Flair, and you, Arn Anderson, don't take the gold away, because the Soul Brothers are going to walk out victoriously Halloween Havoc.
The other day, my little boy crawled up in my lap and he said, Daddy, you're going to take me trick-or-treating on the 27th? I said, son, that's not Halloween. That's Halloween Havoc. The reason we live in this big house, got that big screen, got those two Mercedes-Benz out in the lot. Go to showbiz anytime you want, spend what you want. Your mama owns Louis Vuitton. The reason all those things happen, son, is because I've always been a champion. I've demanded it out of myself at Halloween Havoc. We get another shot, and we're going to make the best of it. It's going to be called the Night of Kings. Halloween Havoc pushed aside when we walk the aisle. It's going to be royalty stepping forth to take the world titles. Halloween Havoc, go ahead. Dude, you're the world champions now, but when we get through with you at Halloween Havoc, we'll be the world champions, and you'll be saying what's causing all that.
And, of course, so it will be a World Tag Team Championship match settled next Saturday night at Halloween Havoc on exclusive pay-per-view. Also, Sid Vicious goes up against Sting, the NWA World Heavyweight Championship on the line. Here's what happened when the contract was signed in Chicago.
Sting, you and your attorneys have also had a chance to review the contract. You can sign for here on October 27th to defend the title against Sid Vicious.
Say to you, pal, don't let your mouth overload your...
The Stinger down. Wait a minute. Here comes Vicious with a steel chair. Sid Vicious attacking Sting with a steel chair. Hits him again. He hit him in the back of the head and now in the back with that chair. He attacked him from behind at the Clash. And he's perpetrated another attack here on the heavyweight champion of the world.
Typical four horsemen style. Very, very nicely done, Sid. From behind, as usual. Nice pile driver. Not just on the mat, but no, you had to get the metal chair, set it down, do it just right, didn't you? Maybe get a little bit of blood coming out of, oozing out of my head. I still got a big headache over that. You make it even a bigger headache. But come time for Halloween, 1 week away now, I might just get revenge and do it back.
Challenger Sid Vicious has joined me now. It's a week from Saturday night. This coming Saturday night in Chicago, Halloween Havoc, I would imagine the butterflies are beginning to mount.
Oh, see, Gordon, when you're a man like I am,
you have no butterflies because you have one thing to do.
And you know how to do it. Sting, Halloween Havoc, I have been training. I've been training harder than I've ever trained in my life. Now it's to the peak. I'm at the peak of my career. And in Halloween Havoc, I'm going to show you to you and the rest of the people in this world exactly why they say Sid Vicious rules.
Excuse me, don't rotate the Paul ponies. Mr. Vicious, sir, would you please bring the world belt to the victory celebration I'm throwing for Stan Hansen?
Let me tell you something, Paul, dangerously. You've interrupted one of my programs today. You're interrupting another one. You're out, and we'll be back.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. The first team to be introduced by their manager. Ooh! opponents, total combined weight 462 pounds. First, from Washington, D.C., Tommy Angel. From Charlotte, North Carolina, Brett Holiday.
Brett Holiday and Tommy Angel to challenge Jim Cornette's Midnight Express. And Bob, with the injury, and again, we don't want to speculate how badly, and we don't know exactly what part of the anatomy that Robert Gibson has been injured, but it does throw a little cloud over the matchup 1 week from tonight, exclusively on pay-per-view at Halloween Havoc between the Midnight Express and the Rock and Roll
Express. That's right, Jim. Rock and Roll and the Midnight, they're going to be meeting. They're scheduled to meet at Halloween Havoc. But, Jim, I tell you, with a tremendous showing that Tommy Rich made in there with Ricky Morton, I really feel like Rich could step right in there and he could do more than a creditable job.
I think you're right. And, Bob, what comments we have heard. Flair, Anderson, ready for Doom. Doom, ready for the Horseman. Sting is, at an all-time high. He is, I think, we'll never see him any better than we will see Sting 1 week from tonight. But will that be enough to offset a 6'9", 330-pound monster like Sid Vicious?
Jim, we have seen Sting wrestle some fantastic matches. We've seen him go 60 minutes in matches that were just tremendous and outstanding. But when I think about it and I look at Vicious and I look at Sting and I think how tremendous he's been in those matches, he is really, I think, going to have to literally wrestle the match of his life to be able to walk out of that ring with a championship.
I want to congratulate Gordon Solie for evicting Paulie Dangerously from the Gordon's wrestling wrap-up set. That was much needed. I may try that myself sometime. Power Hour. As a matter of fact, the Power Hour back with us this coming Friday night. And big news there. We're going to have a great tag team match this coming Friday night on the Power Hour. Ric Flair and Arn Anderson to take on Captain Mike Rotunda and White Lightning Tim Horner. Should be a great battle. Red Holiday with right hands on beautiful Bobby Eaton. And beautiful Bobby trying to position Holiday. And he does. He made the tag. Holiday's unaware of that. No one in wrestling executes a blind tag any better than the Midnight Express.
They do it. They do it right to perfection. And when they do, you know Stan Lane's going to come with one of those karate moves.
Great suplex there. Midnight Express, I think, have to be considered one of the great all-time teams in the National Wrestling Alliance. And with their great, Cornette looks like a, like he went to, where did he get those clothes, Bob? Have you ever seen a jacket with those nice blue jacket with red lapels?
Well, I see him around at a yard sale every now and then, Jim, and I think that's where they come from.
He looks like a flag of some foreign country that slips my mind. Tommy Angel, and boy, he's an outstanding competitor, scooping up Stan Lane and slams him down. Tommy Angel in great condition. And he went for a high-risk move. Much like beautiful Bobby, but Bobby's batting well over 500 in his. Tommy Angel went, he struck out on that with a sweet stand. Those martial arts blows taking over there.
All you fans around the Baltimore area, tomorrow night, World Championship Wrestling will be in Baltimore at the Baltimore Arena. And then Monday night, as Jim mentioned a few moments ago, Monday night at 7:30, Gainesville, Georgia, Georgia Mountain Center. Over 30 great stars there, Jim, and that's going to be our national TV taping. Fans, you can see all the great NWA stars right there at that taping. You don't want to miss that one. It's Tuesday in Sumter, South Carolina, and Wednesday in Savannah, Georgia.
Great teamwork. I'm awfully oftentimes amazed at the chain wrestling moves that the Midnight Express are able to execute. A lot of teams are known for their counter wrestling, for the defensive wrestling, but the Midnight Express, a very offensive-minded team. Inside cradle there by Tommy Angel. And, of course, their manager's about as offensive as anybody I know.
Jimmy is that. But, you know, Cornette, you got to hand him to him. At least he selected this team, and he sort of molded them to what he thinks is his perfection. It's perfection in his eyes anyway, and they certainly are that in a lot of other people's eyes. But they go together with all the pieces. They sort of fit perfectly as a tag team. When you've got Eaton, who's a high flyer, and then you got Stan with the karate moves and the kicking moves, they complement each other so well.
Beautiful Bobby catching Tommy Angel coming into that elbow. Bobby Eaton, one of the greatest performers on a nightly basis in the history of the NWA. And that covers a lot of ground, and I intend for it to. I don't know of anybody in the sport that's any more competitive than beautiful Bobby Eaton.
You can look at any sport and any great star, Jim, and they have off nights. It doesn't make a difference whether it's baseball, football, boxing, or whatever it might be, basketball. But Eaton never seems to have an off night. He's always on top of it.
Now the Midnight Express focusing squarely on the back of Tommy Angel. There you see Stan Lane with those forearms right in the lower back area. Now he's over the top ring cable there, trying to choke the oxygen away from this outstanding young competitor. Tommy Angel trying to reach for the tag for Brett Holiday. Beautiful Bobby with a big right hand.
Well, one of the things you've got to always be aware of when you're in the ring against the Midnight Express, and that is, it's like taking on three. You really got three against you, because Cornette, somewhere or the other, Cornette's going to figure in the match.
Cornette has been known to load that tennis racket with all types of the vaunted international objects. He can really nail you with it. Look at this teamwork here. Bobby Eaton acting like he's the innocent as he was holding on to Tommy Angel. This team doesn't miss a trick. They are just tremendous. Nice move there by Tommy Angel. Good quickness rolling up Stan Lane. And it got two out of it. Near fall there. That was a little bit of a shocking upset there.
But Jim, look how quick it was that Stan Lane got to his feet and was back on the attack again.
Lane now tagging in beautiful Bobby. Midnight Express eating with the elbow. Tommy Angel in a lot of trouble. Needs to tag in Holiday, no doubt about that. Good teamwork again. Just a succession of great offensive moves that we're seeing. What an offensive display. They're the BYU of wrestling. They put the points on the board,
sure,
and
do.
Here comes Holiday back in the match. Reversal there by Sweet Stan. That double martial arts thrust right to the throat area, and Jim Cornette barking out his instructions on the outside. There's a scoop slam by Stan Lane and tagging in beautiful Bobby. And beautiful Bobby now
Watch
will
out.
Fly, and nobody does any better. It's Lane working the referee's count there. He's got a full Nelson on Holiday. And right off the top rope with the knee right to the back of the head on Brett Holiday. What a devastating move. Holiday is out of it. He's limp, Bob.
What is Eaton trying to do to him?
They have knocked this man into Never Never Land.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the Midnight Express.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your Nintendo Power Play, Nintendo Game Boy. Now you're playing with power, and this, a great illustration of power, a great illustration of offensive tag team wrestling, chain wrestling moves.
Tremendous teamwork also by the Midnight Express. Paul Nelson, look at Eaton, how high he gets off of the rope with a knee right to the back of the head.
He had the Boston Crab, the knee right to the back of the head. This one is over. Midnight Express have won it, and we'll be back. The Juicer is next.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Portland, Oregon, weighing 211 pounds, The Juicer!
The Juicer and his Juice Patrol circling the ring. Now this youngster I mentioned earlier in the program, Alan Iron Eagle's 19. This kid right here is 18 years of age. Just got out of high school this past May. And he's jumped right from the frying pan into the fire, as the old cliche would go. And he likes to have his young Juice Patrol pose for the opponent.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, from Louisville, Kentucky, 230 pounds, J.D. Wolf.
J.D. Wolf will be the opponent for the Juicer. And this youngster, we talked about it, the rapid rise by the Nasty Boys up the ladder as J.D. Wolf takes advantage early of the Juicer. This youngster has really captivated the imagination of all the kids.
What is that? I can't tell what it is.
It's all over J.D. Wolf, though. There's that dust flying from the head of the Juicer. He's not the most dapperly attired individual is the Juicer. Maybe if he gets a few winner's paychecks in his bank, he'll be able to buy him a little bit more fashionable ring attire.
Oh, man, it looks like a head of hair would certainly give him hay fever or something in the ring, Jim, as you say, as much dust as he got in it, as he's got in that hair. But I tell you, he's such
Good
an exciting
there.
Individual. Look at this.
He's just circling the top rope as he is walking along the sidewalk. He's a happy kid. He's a fun guy to talk to. Really loves wrestling. And now he's going to take a little break, it looks like.
We gotta go over and get a little refreshment here.
Soft drink there.
Yeah. Jim, it's hard to imagine, though, someone at 18 years of age.
Oh, J.D. Wolf went for a big move there and a big dive. The juicer saw him and moved out of the way. Now keep your eye on the juicer. Here he comes. He made a U-turn right in midair. He may try it again here. This is an explosive. Watch Wolf. Wolf's not seeing him. The juicer between the ropes. What a move.
Well, the first time, as you say, Jim, grabbing the ropes made that U-turn right back into the ring again. That time it was perfect landing outside.
J.D. Wolf is a tough battler. As he kicks the juicer coming back into the ring, Wolf has been in a lot of fisticuffs. A real street fighter. And the juicer looks a little bit dangerous there. There's a slam, and he stomps him right in the solar plexus. I tell you what, this when he needs the fan support, these youngsters are clapping their hands, and they're getting involved. There's another straight right hand by Wolf.
Well, they love him, Jim. He's just tremendous in the ring. Excitement, I guess, is about the only way you can describe this youngster. If he's 18 now, what's he going to be like when he gets a few years' experience under his belt?
Nice move there. That, oh, nice chop. Part of that knee lip. I like that. And there's that sabot kick, much like a super kick. And the juicer throws off that very attractive ring jacket, finally. He's got a Halloween Havoc shirt on. But he and Norman will be there. Nice elevation. Now the juicer goes up to the second turnbuckle. He likes to use the Luthez press. Now he's on the top rope. And here he comes. The Thez press. The juicer's got him wrapped up. And the juicer has won it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the juicer.
We're going to be going to Trucker Norm's corner in a few moments. This kid can use the ropes. You talk about an agile kid. What a great athlete. This is a very, you got to be naturally gifted to be able to do that.
Oh, you're right there. Just tremendous athletic ability. Using the rope certainly to his advantage as the juicer. And as you say, off of the rope, the top rope, with a Thez press. 1, 2, 3, and it's another outstanding win for the juicer.
He probably won't have any chicken fried steak handy. Maybe some in his bib overalls. Let's go now to Trucker Norm's corner.
Hey, look at this. Look at this. We got that juicer right here in Norman's corner right here on TBS. Me and the juicer are happy. We're getting excited. We're on our way up to Chicago for the pay-per-view, juicer.
Halloween Havoc. Me and Norman are going. You know what, Norman? I'm still going to paint your face.
All right. We're going to paint my face. Maybe put on a Halloween costume. Head up there. We're going to hitchhike. We got to hitchhike up there. We're going to have a bunch of fun. I'll tell you, all you little kids out there, if you're not as lucky as me and the juicer to be there, tell your parents to get the pay-per-view and have it come right into your home. Halloween Havoc on pay-per-view. Oh, yeah. Hey.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Los Angeles, California, he weighs 285 pounds, J.W. Storm. His opponent from Panama City, Panama, 250 pounds, James Sullivan.
James Sullivan trying to derail the yet undefeated as far as being pinned. I think he's been disqualified a couple of times, but no one has yet to pin the 6'6", 285-pound J.W. Storm. And Bob, I've tried to have a few conversations with this man. He's one of the most arrogant individuals I've ever seen. He really thinks he's going to, as time goes by, he's going to become the dominant force on World Championship Wrestling. And he says that Sting and Lex Luger are merely targets. He'll have their belts before it's said and done.
Well, Jim, of course, it's a big chunk that he's bitten off right there, but as you say, he may certainly be able to live up to that. Nobody's been able to defeat him to put his shoulders to the mat, that is, as of the moment. Not only that, but he's big, strong, powerful individual. He's got muscles to spare, and ego as big as all outdoors.
Very arrogant man.
Yes, sir.
I've seen young kids try to get him to sign their autograph books. He wholeheartedly refuses. James Sullivan tossed outside, and Sullivan is no junior heavyweight. Sullivan is in that 240 or 50-pound range, and the Bob J.W. Storm just leaped over the top rope. He has got great agility for this a man of his size.
And that's another thing about him, Jim. You don't normally see that in a man as big and as strong, as powerful as Storm is. And we've noticed that in his previous matches. Watch this, as he just jumps flat-footed back up on the ring.
Bob, I've just been handed this by our director. Next week, listen to this, fans. Next week right here, the first time ever on TBS, El Gigante will be wrestling that? Right here on TBS next Saturday night, 6:05 Eastern Time. Be a great program, and we look forward to seeing the 7'7", 450-pounder in action right here from the center stage.
And let me tell you, fans, if you have not seen this big man, oh, you're in for something.
This one's over. Man, he is dominant.
Here's your winner, KW Storm.
He means business. There is no doubt about it. And wait a minute. Keep it right here. Oh, that right hand. That's a vicious right hand. I've heard he was a bouncer in taverns, we should say, and he's used that right hand on more than one occasion.
And again, you can see here the tremendous power and the force of Storm. That big hand right around the throat to slam him hard, to drive him to the mat, to cover him for the count of three.
Ladies and gentlemen, Missy Hyatt and Paul Lee got some comments to make to us about tomorrow night's main event.
Join me, Missy Hyatt, and this guy right here, Paul Lee Dangerously, tomorrow for the main event right here on TBS at 6:05. The main event match will be a six-man tag team bout featuring the Renegade Warriors and Alan Iron Eagle and the Freebirds with the mystery partner.
And guess what, Missy? I know who the mystery partner is.
Yeah, well, I know who it is, too.
Well, who is it, then?
You tell me first.
No, you tell me first.
No, you tell me first.
No, you tell me and then I'll tell you.
Wrestling fans, the following tag team event on World Championship Wrestling, it is set for one fall. Introducing from the heartlands of the South, Tracy's brothers, Steve Armstrong, the Wild-Eyed Southern Boys. And their opponents total combined weight 550 pounds. First, from the Watts section of Los Angeles, California, Mark Kyle. And from Irontown, Ohio, Ralph Hodges.
There's a look at Ralph Hodges and Mark Kyle. They'll take on the Wild-Eyed Southern Boys. What a great team, Bob. I know, Bob, they're probably your favorite team in World Championship Wrestling.
Jim, you know, they are one of my favorites because they're just such fine young men, outstanding people as well as outstanding athletes. But, Jim, I tell you, next week in talking about that, I think you've got something that you want to tell all the fans that may be happening to the Southern Boys next week.
Well, Bob, I've been informed by Dennis Brandt, the editor of the Wrestling Wrap-Up, that next week here on the program, we're going to give the Southern Boys will be receiving from the Wrestling Wrap-Up magazine and from the fans of World Championship Wrestling a very special award. I don't know exactly the nature of the award, but that presentation will be made here next week. I happen to have the chance to talk to Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong a little bit earlier today before we went on the air. They're really excited about next Saturday night and that awards presentation. I got to say, Bob, we can't go to any more deserving young men than these two kids.
Jim, you're right. As I say, they're just outstanding people as well as great athletes in the ring. They've got good size, good power, and they rely mainly on their speed, their quickness, and their athletic skills to carry them.
Mark Kyle and Ralph Hodges a little bit hesitant to get back in the ring. This is a very explosive team. Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong have had some great battles and beaten some of the great teams in the world.
Hey, they've had some memorable matches with the Freebirds. And, Jim, I don't think we'll ever forget some of those matches they had against the Freebirds.
They've had great matches with the Freebirds. They've had some tremendous matches with the Midnight Express and many other great teams, including the World Tag Team Champions, Doom, the Horsemen, and many others.
You don't find a team where you got two men with the size of these two of the Southern Boys. I think, Jim, you find very few teams that have the size, that also have the athletic ability to get around like they do on the ropes, to have the quickness and the speed and all of the other facets that they've got to go with their game.
And, you know, you look at the great teams, a great team perhaps like the Midnight Express, where you have a flyer like Beautiful Bobby, that would be Steve Armstrong, and a martial arts expert like Stan Lane, and, of course, that would be Tracy Smothers.
Right.
And it's not worked very badly, quite obviously, for Jim Cornette's team. It's certainly not working very badly either for the Wild-Eyed Southern Boys. Good arm drag takeover. Mark Kyle, a big, powerful man from the Watts section of Los Angeles. He is a real powerhouse, as Tracy Smothers a little cautious, and rightfully so there. Fans, don't forget, we'll find out tomorrow who will be the mystery partner Freebirds will have on the main event. They say it will be a major star and will shock us all.
That'll be at 6:05 tomorrow, fans, right here on TBS. Quickly, let me remind you that Thursday, you'll see World Championship Wrestling in Toronto, Canada, and Norfolk, Virginia, and then Friday in Saginaw, Michigan, and Richmond, Virginia. All you great fans in those areas certainly will want to see World Championship Wrestling there.
Oh, karate kick there by Tracy Smart, catching Kyle coming in as well. We talked about this kid's explosive martial arts background. Really proficient using his feet. And more than just like Bob, you and I walked in, I know you're a dancer.
Twinkle toes, huh?
That's it.
Hey, Jimmy, you know, we're not going to get an opportunity, I think, to tell the fans about it many more times. And one more time, I'd like to remind them about next Saturday night. That's our pay-per-view Halloween Havoc. The action, you won't want to miss it.
Nice double team move there by the Wild-Eyed Southern Boys. Really double chop Ralph Hodges. Steve Armstrong got him up in that suplex.
Well, he got him high with that suplex too, Jim, and he had a lot of power. He got him and held him right at the apex of that to drive him hard to the mat.
Tracy Smothers over the top rope just met Ralph Hodges very firmly, let's say. Caught him right in the face, and now big Mark Kyle tagged in. Man, you can tell he's been spending a lot of time recently in the gymnasium. But he got an interesting style of his chest there, that little patch of hair looks like a, I don't know what exactly it is. There you see the back of his head.
I guess it looks like a diamond, doesn't it? He's a diamond in the rough or something.
Maybe that's it.
Yeah. But Jimmy's got a lot of confidence. And I think if you're as big and as strong and as tough as he is, you'd have confidence. And he's got it.
It looks like he's got a piece of sod growing on the back of his head because the hair's not growing anywhere else on his head anyway. Side headlock there, right behind. Keeping Kyle off balance right into the hammerlock by Steve Armstrong. Paul Lee and Missy Hyatt both claiming that they know who the mystery partner is. Bob, it's like when two fishermen get together. The first liar doesn't have a chance. Because he's going to, I caught one this big. Well, I caught one
that big.
Twice that big, you know.
Right. Or you should have seen the one that got away, you know. No, I'm with you. I don't think they have any idea, and I don't think anybody's going to be able to pull that out of the Freebirds.
Good drop toe hold by Steve Armstrong. Of course, Steve Armstrong, father, very popular in the Atlanta area, particularly over the years, Bullet Bob Armstrong. Steve's brother, a Candyman, Brad Armstrong, great wrestling family. Steve was... grew up just north here of Atlanta in Marietta, Georgia. Tag made. Well, they made a lot of tags. That's the mark I've always thought of, a great tag team. Switching in and out quickly, keeping your opponent off balance, keeping them in your part of the ring.
Another thing I noticed about them too, Jim, is that as the match progresses, and after you wrestle several minutes, they're just as quick and they're just as strong as when the match began.
Great condition. These kids really work out hard. They really train hard. They eat right. They train hard, as we said. They're just great role models, especially for youngsters.
Good, clean youngsters. You say that makes outstanding role models.
Uh-oh. Mark Kyle just had a misfire there. Knocked old Ralph Hodges off the ring apron. Ralphie boy just got nailed right there in the jaw. Kyle may not have any friends in here at all. Another collar and elbow tie-up, and there's a rake of the eyes. And Kyle with the elbow.
Well, it doesn't matter how quick you are, how strong you are, and how big you are. The eyes, that's another equalizer. Go to the eyes. Boy, you've got him stopped.
Steve Armstrong back in, continuing to work on the arm of Mark Kyle by using the hammerlock now into the wrist lock. Watch him put the pressure on that shoulder. Hammers it with a fist. Another rake of the eyes by Mark Kyle, which has been perhaps his most effective offensive weapon. And Ralph Hodges has been tagged back in.
Well, Hodges, who took a tremendous blow earlier, comes in and he's really met with a flurry of blows.
I don't think he's recuperated, Bob.
Ooh, man,
his eyes looked a little glazed to me when he came in.
Well, if they weren't, they are now. As he got so high with that backflip, he went way high. Look at that, Jim.
High shoulder block. Oh, Mark Kyle all the way over the top rope. He didn't get thrown over. They just dropped out of sight, and there he was, right over the top rope. The wild-eyed Southern boys now turning it up a notch. They got him up there.
Beautiful teamwork here.
Steve Armstrong up on the top. Here comes that drop kick. A tremendous drop kick by Steve Armstrong as the wild-eyed Southern boys have won it here.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the wild-eyed Southern boys.
All right, and fans, again, let's look at the tremendous teamwork right here of the Southern boys. And watch these chops perfectly timed as they land them together. The double block off of the rope now. High to the air with a drop kick. Again, perfect timing, and it landed right on the button with the winners, the Southern boys.
Indeed it was, Bob, a great victory for the Southern boys. Their big award here next week. We look forward to that. I think they're well-deserving of any award that they may receive.
Well, Jim, I think you're 100% right. And also, we don't want the fans to forget next week. We're going to get a look in action of El Gigante. What is this?
Wait. Did I understand you to say the Southern boys are going to get some kind of award next week?
That's right, Tamarni, right here.
What kind of bogus award would they give a couple of rednecks like that? What is it? The Jed Clampett Memorial Award? Maybe the Red Man Chewing Tobacco Hall of Fame Trophy? What if they would give an award to these two guys, it's got to be some kind of joke. Hey, maybe next week, if you're real good, they'll make you the Field and Stream nude centerfold.
Jim, I don't know what this blowhard is saying right here, but the Wild Out Southern boys, we would be very proud to accept the award from the Wrestling Wrap-Up, and especially all these great people out here.
Hey, all right, guys. Hey, well,
he ought to be proud to have a job except pumping gas at some gas station. I think it's funny. I'm going to be here next week. It's going to be better than two episodes of Hee Haw back-to-back. I got to see these guys get an award.
Mr. Ross, we don't need any comments from the peanut gallery.
There you go.
Steve and myself, we'll be here next week because we can't wait to accept that award because that'll be the biggest moment of our career.
Okay, guys, thank you very much. We'll see you back here next Saturday. And fans, don't forget, next Saturday, the first wrestling appearance of El Gigante. And who is the mystery partner for the Freebirds? We'll find out tomorrow night at 6:05. For my partner, Bob Cottle, I'm Jim Ross. So long, everybody.